this week has been great. This week has been considered as the National Volunteer Week. Although volunteerism is something I really encourage and promote all the time, I guess this is like the time that like it's really promoted, this National Week. But I guess the week is over, because I tend to view Sunday as the last day of the week. You might consider it as the beginning of a new week. So in that case, National Volunteer Week is over. But that doesn't mean that you shouldn't volunteer. In any case, I bring this up, the National Volunteer Week up, because the topic of giving is pretty important to me. I really value giving. And volunteerism is a sort of giving. You're giving your energy and time. But of course, when I'm talking about giving, I'm talking about giving money. And even though I'm in a bad financial situation, I guess my financial priorities aren't that straight, because I do tend to still give or try to give a lot. As far as like who do I give to currently, the most consistent one I give to is this organization, Compassionate Cooks. So they're a vegan organization, and I came through learning about it through the podcast, you know, Food for Thought, Compassionate Cooks. And as I listened to it, it was a really amazing resource for me as a starting vegan. I really appreciated the help they gave me, so that's why I donated, became like a monthly subscriber, monthly giver, I guess. So I give them $35 a month, and it's a yearly thing. So I don't know if I'll actually continue doing that for the next year, just because my money situation ain't that great, but I'm still continuing to do that. And other times, of course, some events come up or something, and I end up giving, like this current, most recent situation with Japan, you know, the earthquake and the nuclear reactor thing. I donated to the American Red Cross, and I usually, you know, I guess it was just convenient. I would like to find out more local organizations that provide help, but I did that. I really didn't donate that much. I gave like, what, $10, I think. I think it was like $10 or $15, stuff like that. And, you know, any organizations I come up, I like to donate. And as far as donating to organizations go, I think public perception is, you know, it's a good thing. Most people would most people think that's a really good thing and would like to do that. But the controversial thing is, of course, giving to actual individuals. You know, especially because I live in New York City, I see a lot of this. People who are clearly homeless, you know, they're on the streets begging for money, stuff like that. I think the general perception is that they don't really like to give to individuals, but I actually really value giving money to individuals. If I have any cash on me, and I only tend to keep very little cash with me at a time and keep rest of my money in my debit card, but when I do have little cash, I tend to try to make it into smaller bills, not only so that I could pay for going to the laundromat, but also to actually give to people that I just feel compelled to give. I like giving to individuals. And I think I brought this up one time. I was on Game Trailers of all sites, you know. And this is like the site I actually least expected to talk about the topic series like this. But a Game Trailers user did his usual like sales chart blog, right, on video games related stuff, and he's a user I really respect. He and I share a lot of comments very frequently on that Game Trailers channel about and pretty much everything related to games, and especially because our opinions on games really differ. But this time, I guess I brought up the notion that I'm not really doing well financially and blah blah blah, and then he brought up, like, well, you have an iPhone, so you must be doing pretty well for yourself. And anyway, one conversation, one topic led to another. And I brought up one thing, and it led to this topic. I said, oh, so I kind of compiled, I selected parts of our comments back and forth. And this is kind of what started the discussion. I said, by the way, I wasn't, like, rich before. I just didn't have to make huge monthly payments to Citibank. Without that $864 a month I have to pay, that's my student loan payment, which I'm not currently able to make. Anyway, I could even work less hours and live so much more comfortably without that loan, and donate a lot more. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, my $1,000 a month living expenses actually include about $60 or so that I donate to charities and individuals. yeah, my financial priorities are a bit messed up. So that brought up my giving to individuals, right? This giving to charities and organizations and whatnot. And so he responded back, wow, good job on donating. I only donate $10 a month to Amnesty International, and I give blood 3 times a year. Been thinking about volunteering locally, but with school, I just am too damn busy, and you recommended charities. And that's when I bring up, this is me responding. Currently, I donate most to Compassionate Cooks, an animal rights and vegan organization. I'm a monthly contributor to that one. Amnesty International is a great one to donate to. A lot of the times, I walk in the streets of New York City, or I'm riding the subway, and I meet people needing money, and I'm really good at refusing. So that's what I mean by donating to individuals. It also includes those street musicians who are so talented. I feel bad for just walking past them, so I donate to them. So that's kind of what starts it off. And then, of course, his response was kind of what I expected. I mean, it is the general, perception. So I guess I'll read that off. So he responds, I never donate to individuals. I met some pretty addicted heroin addicts in the past. And after that, I realized that half the time I donate to individuals, they will just use it on drugs. One time I was in a bar with a group of friends celebrating the end of term. This woman came crying more than I'd ever seen anyone cry before and said this story of how she has no change to go home and her boyfriend just broke up with her. Makes sense, but she said she needed $10 for the train and the train cost $2 to $3. We said we would give her some money, but before we realized what her problem was, she ran to the bar across the street. The bartender told us she was a heroin addict and that people like her come in all the time. They have no money for their drug, so they do stupid things like it to make it fast. Watch A Requiem for a Dream, and you will see how sad some people's lives get due to drugs. So, you know, I watched Requiem for a Dream. Actually, I made a video talking about my thoughts on Requiem for a Dream, so that's, I guess, he didn't know I watched it. I thought that was like a propaganda for Dare. That was my analogy to that movie. Anyway, 40% of homeless people have some form of schizophrenia or bipolar. 10% of them are supposed people who are born with it, the other 30% develop it due to bad conditions. I don't think giving these people change will help them out. Only 5 to 10% of people become homeless for unusual reasons, like living with someone depending on them and being kicked out with no place to go, or Walmart closing in a small community. So that's pretty much his argument against donating to individuals. And this was my response back, kind of, you know, because I'm kind of used to that response. So I responded back. In regards to donating to individuals, yeah, I guess the biggest worry is that it's not going to where you want it to go, or people who take the donation aren't going to spend it the way you want them to. But I just think these people need help anyway. I would love to actually help them in a more involving way than just giving money, like it's the social work in me, lol. But a lot of the times, that's all I can do. Will a lot of them use the money I give for their drug habits? Sure, I don't doubt that. But they're leading such destructive lives without social support. And my internship in college actually had me helping out many of these people who had substance abuse issues. It's much beneficial for them and for the overall society to help these individuals instead of condemning them like they're some kind of criminals. And there's a hidden fact that about 25% of homeless people actually have jobs. And about 15% of homeless people work 2 jobs. In fact, my college friend is a single parent raising 2 kids, and she's homeless, and she's going to graduate college within a few months. I donate to individuals not really because I feel that money is being spent the right way, and I know in some cases it may have been used for drug habits or whatever, but I do it because I feel like I'm making a direct impact on someone's life. And it's just not... And it's not just money for some of these people. Interesting writing. Sometimes I write crappily. That's my fault, though. I've engaged in pretty amazing conversation with these people and learned about their life stories just by taking the time to give them something. One homeless person I met, I refused to accept money from me. He refused to accept money from me, but he instead wished to talk with me for 30 minutes and share his dream of one day owning a barbershop and providing for his daughter living hundreds of miles away in Washington, D.C. I think that overall, our society needs to have a different attitudes about the homeless and about to be homeless. And while I don't know, I didn't know they were homeless type of people. To paint this entire group as the stereotypical image of drug addicted, lazy individuals has been very, very damaging to the American nation as a whole. I know you're Canadian, and so I don't know, you don't know how blah blah blah. Skip on the Canadian part. Aside from that, those street musicians I donate to, come on, they got talent. They really deserve my money. Homelessness and reentry once released from prison have always been my biggest interest, but there are other interests too. So that's I guess, what I talked about. That was my response back, and then we shared back and forth this idea of, you know, what's problematic about giving to individuals, and, you know, why I think it's really needed to, you know, even though that a lot of the, I mean, he brings up really good arguments. You know, a lot of the best argument I saw him bring back is that people, the homeless people that really do need help are the invisible ones. The ones that we need to give money to, you know, or about to be homeless are the invisible ones. They're not on the street begging for money. They're not visible. They're working. You know, they're having two jobs and they're homeless. You know what I mean? So those kind of people, even though we should, they will be the ones who will be using the money the most wisely, probably, logically speaking. But we can't, because they're so invisible, we wouldn't be able to give the money. So we would actually be giving the money to people who would probably be using it on their drug habits, or probably money that wouldn't be using the right way, right? So that was, I think, was probably the strongest arguments I hear from, and I agree with that. Let's see, but I think I made another response that kind of had to do with that. Let me look through this. So that's that, and then actually our conversation reached one thing to another. So we go from like talking about donating to poverty, all the way down to like how our criminal codes should work. It's very interesting how we did back and forth of that. Let's see. Now, I think this is the key point I said, and like I said, I do understand that many do use money I give on drugs and alcohol or whatever. That's probably a part of their spending for many of them. But I guess the thing is, I'm just okay with that. I know most people aren't, but after reading a lot of research on the effects of illicit drugs on people, and especially after meeting and engaging with people who regularly do inject or sniff up drugs, I know the struggles they have to go deeper than just their behavior or lifestyle. Because they're living and surviving, I'm also fairly certain that they need money for food and clothes as well. You're probably right about the ones who most likely use the money the right way won't be the ones begging on the streets. Though in America, a good portion of the homeless population begging on the streets are people like Vietnam War veterans, and they really are begging for money for food or for food. I've seen plenty of those people go into food shop as soon as they got money from someone. I spotted a couple who are very, very glad to accept some canned food. Once I give, though, I just give. It's not up to me to dictate how that money should be spent. I do hope that money ends up helping people, and I'm almost always pretty sure that it did help. But beyond that, I do understand that it might not be used the way I would have liked or wanted it to. And I just accept that. If I don't, then I wouldn't be donating at all, and I think that doing something is better than nothing, even when a little bit of that something may actually not be helping. So I guess that's kind of my response. But to me, I still feel, even though I would love to give to those invisible homeless people, or the invisible about to be homeless people, even people in my situation, you know, who is kind of just struggling so hard living from paycheck to paycheck and not being able to meet loan payments, whatever, or being in debt payment. Even just donating to people like me would be great if I knew that they needed help. But like he says, these aren't the people begging on the streets. These are the people you would never expect that they need help. But even so, like, just donating, I think, is great, because just they have to survive somehow, and you know, even the people who do drugs or whatever, they have aspirations, they have hopes, they have taste, they have preferences, and I think whatever I can do to help other people is something I should do.